أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. نحمد ونصلي على رسوله الكريم. أما بعد، فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Today's topic is praying Salah on time. So we all know it's one of the five pillar of Islam. Salah is one of them and most important pillar. And when we die, the first question will be asked regarding this is Salah. So when someone prays, he is known to be a Muslim and he is worshipping only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who is the creator. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَمَا خَلَقْتَ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. Jinn and ins were created only for the ibadah. We have to do ibadah no matter what. So here we see Surah Al-Baqarah, Ayah number 238 and 239. حافظوا على الصلاة والصلاة الوسطى وقوموا لله قانتين. Take due take care of all prayers and the middle prayer and stand before Allah in total devotion. So one have to submit yourself when you stand for the prayer. And حافظوا. So you have to حافظ. You have to guard. على الصلاة والوسطى. And, you know, protect your salah, guard your salah. It means when you pray, you have to guard also. Don't untie it. What does it mean? Inshallah, we'll see in the following ayahs how salah will stop from, you know, fahsha and munkar. So here talking about doing a prayer on time, especially middle prayer. Talking about asar prayer. And if you neglect asar prayer, they will be in total loss. They will be in khasara. And in worldly sense, we think a person is in khasara or total loss when he or she lost the job or financially low. But here, one who is not doing the salah on time, especially the salatul wusta. فَإِنْ خِفْتُمْ فَرِجَالًا أَوْ رُكْبَانًا فَإِذَا آمِنْتُمْ فَاسْكُرُوا اللَّهَ كَمَا عَلَّمَكُمْ مَا لَمْ تَكُونُوا تَعْلَمُونَ. But if you are in fear, then pray on foot or riding. Even though you are in fear, then also Allah is saying you have to pray. So you are not exempted, isn't it? You have to pray on foot or riding. But when you are in peace, recite Allah's name as He has taught you what you did not know. فَاذْكُرُوا اللَّهَ كَمَا عَلَّمَكُمْ مَا لَمْ تَكُونُوا تَعْلَمُونَ. So we have to pray how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has asked us to do. Salah has many benefits. One of them is that it's way of communication to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You know, it's from our childhood when we born, azan is given in our ear. As we grow up, we started learning name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we started saying kalma. So first thing we learn is the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, isn't it? And we start reciting Suratul Fatiha, the opening of the surah, opening of the Quran. And here the main purpose of our life is to do ibadah. And purpose of salah is to bring ourselves closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and a deep-rooted relationship. Because you are thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the blessing. Every day you do salah and you are more and more thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you pray, proclaim the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allahu Akbar. It's not like just doing the actions, but you totally submit yourself. Like, you know, when you stand in prayer, you are totally committed and you are totally humble yourself. That posture you would not do for anyone, isn't it? I'm talking about Muslims. When they completely submit, especially when they do sujood, prostration, that is the most humble way. Even when you go in ruku, how you bend down? Do you bend down for any person? Do you do sujood for any person? No. We are doing only for the sake of Allah. And now many people, they discover and say because of sujood and because of ruku, people have good health, better health. That is the Allah's hukum. That's the amar of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah said so. That's it. We are doing it. And all the benefits, now we are discovering, oh, because of this and that. The famous hadith everybody knows, Even though all the body parts are burned in hellfire, God forbid, if you go to hellfire, the parts of the Sala will not burn. The seven parts, the seven body parts, especially talking about doing the sujood, the forehead part. So it means that even Muslim, practicing Muslim, can go to hellfire, because there it's mentioned about the body parts and especially the marks of the, you know, when you pray. And also in one of the hadith it says, when you do wudu, your body parts of the wudu will shine. But it was in a positive manner, but this was in a negative manner. So Salah protects you. But when we see Salah stops you from, inna salata tanha anil fahshai wal munkar wala zikrullahi akbar. Surely Salah restrains one from shameful and evil acts. Salah will stop you from shameful and evil acts, isn't it? But sometimes some people think, oh, even though I'm praying, but still there is no change. You have to check yourself. What is the problem with you? Whether you are doing Salah on time, whether you are doing according to the Sunnah way, or check, is there anything wrong with it? Maybe the recitation, maybe the wudu you are not doing properly, maybe you are not cleaning yourself, you know, body cleaning, and all the clothes should be clean. And also remove all the things from your heart. If something is bothering, just forgive and forget. Total submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because fahsha and munkar, what is fahsha and munkar? Fahsha, indecent acts, all the shameful acts, and also backbiting, bad behavior, also bad language, all the munkar things which is forbidden in Islam. Fahsha and munkar, indecent can be thing, you know, even watching on the, you know, screen, or like yourself involving it in the haram, all those acts. But here it says it will stop. One of the hadith, a person came, a Bedouin came and asked, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, a person in the daytime he prays, but in the night time he steals. He's a thief. So what will happen? But you say fahsha and munkar will be stopped, like a person prays and it will stop them from these things. So Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, yes, it will. So don't be judgmental for the people. It will stop them one day. They will stop from fahsha and munkar. So don't be judgmental and start saying the things which we are not supposed to say. And what else? الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا تَطْمَئِنَ قُلُوبِهِمْ بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ أَلَّا بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ تَطْمَئِنَ قُلُوبِ. The one who believe and their hearts are peaceful with the remembrance of Allah. So here, not literally talking about Salah, but indirect way, remembrance of Allah. How we do zikr? Zikr are in three forms. One, zikr of Allah, when you do simple zikr, subhanallah, alhamdulillah. And the second zikr, which we do the recitation of the Quran. And the third is the when you recite Quran in the Salah. How we start? Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen Ar-Rahman. So you recite Quran, isn't it? So that is also so. Because of that zikr, how it is? Allazina amanu tatmaina qulubihim. They have itmanan qulub. They have peace and tranquility in their heart. Why? Bi zikrillah. Ala bi zikrillahi tatmaina qulub. Because of the zikr of Allah, your heart have that tatmain al qulub. Believe me, if you take any medicine, anything, it will not give you peace and tranquility unless until you start praying regularly, regularly on time. And today's topic is doing Salah on time. Allah never said they are not doing prayer. Allah said kusala, they pray lazily. Why? Because they are munafiqun. Munafiqun, they pray lazily. They delay the time. They, you know, they exceed the time. And the edge, they will pray. So what we have to do? Pray on time. Why don't we avail that? We want full marks from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, isn't it? We want our salah to be like how it should be. Salah should have those qualities, isn't it? We don't want salah to be thrown away, isn't it? So here we have to do salah in a recognized manner, how Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam taught us. And here, وَأَقِيمُوا الصَّلَاةَ طَرْفَ النَّهَارِ وَزُلْفًا مِنَ اللَّيْلِ إِنَّ الْحَسَنَاتِ يُذْهِبْنَ السَّيِّئَاتِ ذَلِكَ ذِكْرًا لِلذَّاكِرِينَ. Establish salah at both ends of the day. Both ends of the day. Like, you know, when you start your morning, you start with the salah, Fajr salah. And you end your night again with the salah, with the isha. You end your night and you go to sleep. And in the early hours of the night, surely good deeds erase bad. Here it says, inna hasanat yuzhimna sayyat. Hasanat will erase the sayyat. Sayyat is from all the bad evil deeds. And zalika zikra li zakirin. That is a reminder for the zakirin, mindful ones. So salah will erase your sins. But you have to hafizu salatil wusta. You have to guard your salah, isn't it? You don't have to just doing it and, you know, and wasting it. So when you talk about wiping out your sins, so do salah on time. Do the way it has to be done according to the way Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam has taught. Not only this, it says, Ya ayyuhallazina amanu istainu bis sabri was salat. Inna allaha ma'as sabirin. Ya ayyuhallazina amanu, those who believe, istainu bis sabri was salat. Seek help through patience and prayer. It comes patience and prayer. They are interlinked. When you don't have patience, you can't pray. You know, if you are very hasty in praying, you can't do. And it will not be accepted. Like for salah, you should have patience. That's what Allah said. I am not being judgmental. I am not criticizing. What is the hukum of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? To do on time, to do with khushu and khuzu. So the way it has to be taught by Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So our main goal here to do the ibadah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and one of the main pillar is the pray. And many people, when they started praying regularly, their huzn, their grief, their problems, everything is gone. Subhanallah, they have peace of mind, they have peace of heart. Even non-Muslims, they were looking for something, you know, they were not happy. Even though they are getting all the worldly benefits they want, but still their heart don't have the peace and tranquility. When they convert and when they start praying, they had that peace and tranquility. Because when you stand for the prayer, all the things, you know, you forget. You only completely submissive towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when we submissive towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah will listen to us. But if you are, like, you know, not submissive towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what will happen? When you talk to somebody, if you are not giving importance to the other person, how it will be? This is Rabbul Alameen. So you have to give that priority. We have to submit ourselves completely. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Ya ayyuhan insanu ma gharraka bi rabbikal kareem. O man, what has deceived you about your Lord? Allazi khalaqa fasawwaka fa'adala. And here, who created you, then perfect you and brought you in due proportion. So yeah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you the proportion. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made you in that manner. Then why we don't do that? And also it mentioned, فَخَلَفَ مِنْ بَعْدِهِمْ خَلْفٌ أَدَاءُ السَّلَاةَ وَالتَّبِيُّ شَحْوَاتٍ فَسَوْفَ يَلْقَوْنَ غَيَّةٌ. Then came after them the successor who neglected Salah and followed their selfishness, their desires. So they will soon face the outcome of their deviation. Because فخلف, like you know, من بعدهم خلف, then came after the successor, one after the other, and they neglected Salah and follow their own desires. What happens, you know, when Salah time comes, you say, oh, I will do it, I will do it, and you keep neglecting it. One Salah, another Salah, and you do Qaza, and after that you stop doing Qaza, and you think, no, I can't do it, you know, it's very hard for me, I am not in wudu, I am not purified now, so on and so forth. You start making excuses, and Shaitan will zayyana amaluhum shaitana, and Shaitan made your deeds very beautiful, and you think, oh, many people are not praying, so what if I don't pray, nothing will happen. And I have seen from older age to younger age to the more younger, they stop praying, they are neglecting prayers, and now they say, I have this problem, that problem. When we are not submissive to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, how can we say all these things? So we have to pray no matter what. And you know what happens if you don't pray? مَا سَلَكُمْ فِي السَّخَرِ قَالُوا لَمْ نَكُمْ مِنَ الْمُسَلِّينَ. What has brought you to Sakhar? Sakhar is hellfire. They will say, we were not among those who offer Salah obligatory prayer. قَالُوا لَمْ نَكُمْ مِنَ الْمُسَلِّينَ. They were not doing Salah. So what will be the end result if they are not praying Salah? مَا سَلَكُمْ فِي السَّخَرِ. They will be in Sakhar. So they will be asked, what has brought you in the Sakhar, in the hellfire? Because they were not praying. So when you don't pray, what will happen? When you don't pray, you will go to hellfire. So not praying and praying kusala, praying lazily. You know, sometimes we pray, but so lazily. As if, you know, we are doing some ihsan on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No. Allah don't need us. Allah is ghani. Allah don't need us at all. But we think like Allah need us. No. So we have to understand. So Surah Al-Mu'minun, what it says, قَدْ أَفْلَحَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ أَلَّذِي هُمْ فِي صَلَاتِهِمْ خَاشِعُونَ. Who concentrate their attention to humbleness when offering Salah. They have صَلَاتِهِمْ خَاشِعُونَ. They do with khushu. وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ أَنْ لَغْوِ الْمُعْرِضُونَ. Who keep them away from vain things. And also, you know, how the list goes on. But here the main thing talking about Salah, how they do it. And also it talks about in ayah number 9 in that same surah, وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ عَلَى صَلَاتِهِمْ يُحَافِظُونَ. And who consistently observe their Salah prayers. You know, they protect the Salah. We do Salah, but we do many things which destroy our Salah. The first thing will be asked, as I mentioned, is the Salah. What is the thing that distinguish between man and disbelievers? That is the Salah. That is the authentic narration. It's in Muslim. Another narration, Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, whoever keeps on performing prayer in due time, you know, delaying, it will be light, a proof and redemption for him on the day of judgment. Otherwise, he will be assembled with Pharaoh, Qarun, Haman and Ubay ibn Khalf. This is in Ahmad. One who missed his prayer has to suffer in this world and the hereafter. There are many ayahs related to this, you know. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned mankind, what has deceived you? Gharrakum, your Lord, the most generous. Why you are deluded in this world? You have to pray no matter what, you have to pray. So many generations before that, they didn't pray. But what happened? They will be given respite for some time. But Allah will catch in this world all and also in the hereafter. So what is the thing that distinguish between a person and the mu'min? That is the salah. This is in Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, the covenant between us and them consist of prayer. Whoever leaves it has disbelieved. This is in Tirmidhi. So in other words, distinguishing a characteristic of a Muslim in his praying, the 5 daily prayer in their prescribed time, Salatul Mawquta, on time. You know, many times we think, oh, we are just, I'm done. How you are done? Do it on time. So the best way to do it is be in wudu all the time. As soon as time comes, I know how much time it will take. You can recite smaller sunnah, surah, it doesn't matter. But you know, when you are assigned some duty, you do it, isn't it? When you are at work, you do it. But why don't you do this thing, you know? So here we have to pray on time, and it will stop you from fahsha and munkar, and you have to safeguard and protect your salah no matter what. This is the first thing that will be asked, and that will be distinguishing between mu'min and a kafir. We want to be a mu'min, we don't want to be a kafir, isn't it? Jazakallah khairan kaseera.